right, Jaden, what game are we playing today?
Volt Robot Battle Arena.
Nice. Robot Battle Arena, sweet.
Oh,
yeah. Do you like it?
I do. I enjoy this game
a lot. Oh, why?
Because it's a game that's simultaneously a race and a destruction derby.
Yeah. Demolition derby?
Yeah, that too.
Which typically ends up being kill each other.
Yeah.
Nice. Well, we've got another robot game with a grid and programming robots, Robo Rally. Is it like Robo Rally?
Well, it does have similarities. No, it's a totally different game.
Oh, sweet. Good. Yeah. But a good thumbs up for it too.
Yeah.
Sweet. Well, let's find out what it's all about.
In Volt, you want to be the first robot to collect 5 victory points.
Okay. Easy enough?
You can get them by either capturing objectives or being the final person to take a shot that destroys a robot.
So you destroy somebody else's robot?
Yes.
Okay, do they come back?
They do.
They respawn. Yeah. Cool. All right.
Let's talk about some setup. So before the game, you choose your board. There's 2 boards. Each of them is double-sided, so every map is different, as you can
tell.
Okay, nice. And they've
got numbers and blank spots on them?
Yeah. After that, everybody chooses the starting spot for their robot. Normally, you start on the outside, but in this later example, we're going to be later in the game.
Okay.
When you start each round, there's this blue dice. You roll this dice, and where this number lands is where the victory point token will be going that turn. For this demonstration, let's say I rolled a 5. So each round you have 3 dice, red, blue, and white. They go in order of red will be resolved first, then the white, and then the blue dice will be resolved.
Nice. I love that these little shields keep that in your mind. Okay?
Keeps it nice and easy to remember. Turn order goes as follows, as you can see over here. First of all, you'll choose your number, your pips, and put them down on your little programming sheet. Okay. Then you resolve them in order of movement and then firing. Finally, you resolve if you're on the number with the victory point. And then at the end, any robots you happen to have got destroyed that round will be placed back on the board.
Okay. Oh, that's nice. All right. Well, it sounds like it's all about programming your dice.
Yeah. Let me show you how this round played out. So I see myself here and I think, well, the victory point is here. I want to get to that so I can, you know, get a victory point.
Perfect.
So I think, all right, red first. I'm going to take my red dice and I want to move forward 2 spaces. So I put it here.
Okay, so how do these grids work?
These grids are movement and firing a laser based on your point of view. The one with 4, which will be on your left, is the movement. The grid with more spaces, 8, will be on your right.
So you can fire diagonally.
But nice. Everyone is based on your point of view. It doesn't matter which direction your robot is facing. My robot could be facing this direction. It wouldn't change my movements whatsoever.
Okay. So those are based off of the grid orientation.
Yes.
Okay.
So I say, I'm going to want to move forward 2. Red dice goes first. I take 2 pips for 2 movement and put it forward.
Okay, so he'll move forward 2.
So I'll move forward 2. And then I think, where do I think other robots will be going? Green and blue have been having a fight this whole time, so I figure they're going to be going at each other, which means green or blue would have to move in this general area. So I'm going to take a laser, white dice, and I'm going to fire it off in that general direction.
So you're going to fire off
I'm
going to
fire with a 4 laser. I'll explain what each of the different lasers do later.
Okay.
And then I'm going to want to end my space on this. So if I'm right here, I'll want to move 1, 2, 3 to the left. So I put my blue and final dice, 3 pips, to the left.
Can you move 3 times?
You cannot move 3 times. You can move a max of 2 times.
Okay, so always one of your dice has to, at least one of your dice has to keep on firing.
You have to fire the laser at least once per turn.
Or you could just sit there and fire off 3.
Or you could do that, your choice.
Okay.
So let's show you how this round worked out.
Okay, so everybody programmed their
Everybody's
robots.
Is programmed. You
okay,
everybody
let's
can
reveal
their programming. And it looks like it's going to be an interesting round.
Of course.
So let's see. Red dice, as we can see right here, will be going first. I noticed that everybody has a red dice with a 2 pips.
So everybody picked the same. 2 pips.
Everybody picked the same.
So what happens when they're tied with the
When it's a tie for pips, then it goes in the order of you'll move first, and then you'll fire lasers. So did anybody fire a laser with their red 2? No, they didn't.
They're all movement, so they're all on the same portion.
So
they're
all the same. So the next way to resolve a tie is to count the total pips. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
Okay.
Red has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Mm-hmm.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
Actually, they're at 12.
That too, counting. Okay,
so it looks like this one goes red.
So red will be going first. Okay. If it happened that the pips were the same, you can use these. Everybody draws one, and it'll determine turn order that way.
Okay.
So red will go first. They'll move this direction, 2. 1, 2. Then I think I was the next one.
Yep.
And so I'll move forward to this direction.
Okay, and then this one.
And then he will move to
this one also.
This way.
Yep. So go ahead. Yeah, he moved 2 backwards.
And green will move 2 to the left. His right. My forward directions.
Exactly.
They're somewhere.
Okay. All right, everybody moved.
Everybody's moved. Red dice is done. This, you can take it off your sheet to help clear that up, but don't turn it because the pips might be counted again to determine turn movement.
So after red, then white.
Next up comes white. So
it looks like everybody's shooting.
A 5, a 3, or a 3. So lower numbers shoot first or move first.
Okay.
So they have 3, so they're contending for this.
Actually, this guy is.
Oh, wait, movement. He's moving. So they'd be contending, but since he's moving, he'll go first. He moves 3, 1, 2, 3. That's his turn. Gonna take that off.
Okay.
Then this 3 will go next. Looks like he fired this direction with a 3. Nothing was hit. Shame. Next up, I have a 4. That means it'll be my turn to fire.
All right, now tell us how.
And this is where it gets interesting.
Because you're shooting 4 diagonally.
4 diagonally.
From where you are.
So I will be shooting diagonally 1, 2, 3. I'll be shooting in that direction. Notice the pips do not determine how far your laser travels. Your laser will go an infinite distance. What the lasers do determines this, as you can see in the middle.
Okay.
2s and 3s will rotate dice of the firing, and the firing only. They'll rotate them, as I'll show you in just a minute, by 45 degrees, basically one spot. 4s and 5s will be moving every dice 90 degrees.
Of the person
of the person who's hit.
So green is getting hit on this turn.
Yes. And then the 6 will push their robot away from your robot one space.
Okay.
So I shot with a 4. The 4 means all their dice will be moving 90 degrees to the right. So I shoot here, and his dice would move here and here.
Oh, so he just got messed up.
But there's one more issue.
Okay.
Anytime your robot takes a laser hit, no matter what laser, you take a damage token.
Okay.
I give a damage token to green. I notice he already has 2. This puts him at 3 damage. His robot is therefore destroyed. And for being the one who gave him a destroying shot, I get a victory point.
Sweet. Nice move.
So green is out for the rest of this round.
But even if he hadn't been out,
this would have driven him into a pit.
Yeah, he would have run right off into that pit.
So he was doomed anyway.
Because of you messing up his dice.
Yes, indeed.
So that's why it's fun to hit each other.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you take them out.
All right. Okay. So everybody has finished their dice.
Next
up is blue.
So it looks like
red has the lowest pips on blue, so they'll move one space here.
Perfect.
Looks like they ended up on the thing.
Right where he wanted to end up.
Then I move, and I have a 3. So 1, 2, and you push other robots. So 3. So unless he was going into a wall, I can push him.
So because you went second because of your number of pips in space,
that means
sweet.
So
you're going to get the point.
So I'm going to, just as I think I'm about to win, I look at blue. Blue is firing with a 6 straight toward me. 6, if you remember correctly, pushes robots back a space. I end up in a pit. I'm destroyed, and blue gets a victory point.
Because he knocked you out.
Woo! And so that's one round.
And you do that till someone gets 5 victory points.
Yep.
Looks like we got 2 robots to respawn.
The end of that round, you say, okay, I'm going to start my robot somewhere along the edge. Still there, I'm going to want to be here. Green is mad with blue. He's going to come out here.
He's going to come out firing.
Yeah.
Sweet, a lot of chaos then.
A ton.
A little destruction. That's why it's a battle arena, huh?
Yeah.
Well, sweet. Well, what would you rate Volt?
I would rate Volt a 4. 4 out of 5.
Nice. Now, it could play 2 to 4. Is it fun with 2?
It's fun with 2. It's a lot more fun with 4, but any amount's fun with this game.
More the merrier. Sweet.
Always.
All right. Thanks, Jaden.
All right. See ya.